Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see about what is Allselected DAX function. We already seen what is all and all except DAX function does. And we will try to complete it, compare the all with Allselected. Then in what scenarios you will use Allselected. Let us try to see in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button to learn the concepts in Power BI and DAX. We are in Power BI now. You can see here, this is calculating a simple sales amount by product. Okay. Now, this is measure, that is percentage category sales, is calculating the total amount. For each row, this 513000 is divided by this total and you get this percentage calculation. Let us quickly see this formula, which was written using the all function. So divide total sales and all sales. Let me zoom in. So this is the formula, total sales and all sales. The formula for total sales is pretty simple. That is sum of sales amount. And for all sales, this is again calculating the sales amount for the all the sales, irrespective of any filter applied. You can apply this filter or here, it will not consider anything. All the sales divided by, that will be calculated here. So let us try to demonstrate. If you click on Bangalore, this sales amount is filtering for Bangalore, but all sales is not filtering. Even if you filter casual wear, so this sales amount filter for Bangalore and casual wear, but all sales is not filtering since you used all. This is fine. This is the default behavior of all sales. Then what is the issue? Now, there is no issue. There will be scenarios like when you click on Chennai or Hyderabad, any location, you can see here, this percentage category sales is filtered for Chennai. That is 33.76. So it is not splitting based on the, it should contribute to 100%, right? For this Chennai, this should become 100%. So basically, what it has to do is like, it has to keep the external filters, okay? Then ignore other filters in the context. That is what it has to do. So let us, instead of all sales, let us try to say all selected sales. New measure. Let me try to create new measure. Instead of all sales, all selected sales. So here I will say all selected. So this is the one. Then similarly for category, percentage category, I need to replace all sales with the all selected sales. Let us try to do it. Percentage category selected, all selected. Okay, this is for naming convention. Here we need to use all selected sales. So let us try to view this measure in this table. All selected sales. Now you can see, let us make it as percentage to make it meaningful results. Be with me. I clicked on it. It's measure tools, percentage. Absolutely fine. Now you can see without any filter, both behave same. But what happens as soon as you choose Hyderabad? You see here that this is based on all calculation and this is based on all selected. So all will ignore all the filters, but all selected will keep the external filters. That is what it is. This is what we want. So if you see here, what it does is like all divide the total sales. The total sales is simple calculation. This is the sum for this accessory and all selected sales, all selected, which gets all the filters. This one, even you can go for formal or any other date combination. any external filters, those will be filtered. Then for that you compute the percentage. So let us try to see all sales. Now you see all selected of sales. So here you can even go for a particular column. So all selected will have a column as well as a table. For simplicity, I put the table, but performant efficient, if you want to use only for a particular calculation, you can always go for a single column reference. I hope you understand the concept behind the all selected function, when to use it. If you like this video, hit the subscribe button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.